How does it feel to be nominated in so many categories this year?
Well, it's amazing, of course, as always. And in this third series of the show, it feels even more special. I don't know, after a couple of series, you know, interest sort of wanes away. But to be nominated for things on a third series is really special, yeah. The reaction I've got to it has been this incredible sort of emotional response to it. I've had people coming up to me in the street who I get the feeling would never normally come up to someone they recognise off the television, but in this case they make an exception and come up and thank me for it. And it's a really heartwarming reaction to the show. I think that's what I'm most proud of. I sometimes doubt whether the series would have even been made if Toby hadn't been attached from the outset, because it made people sit up and listen to this idea that didn't jump off the page at you. You know, it's a quirky story about hobbyists, but Toby came on board very early on, and I basically wrote the part for him, and initially he was a much more brutish character, but when Toby came on board, it was obvious he was going to be a very wise man and a compassionate man, and so it informed the tone of the series. Well, there's Britannia, of course. We're waiting to hear that if that's been commissioned for a second series, and everybody's hoping it has, and everybody's sort of expecting it to. So I'm hoping to be working on that in this year, and I'm working on other writing projects, so I've got a full slate.
Of course, with Britannia, we love seeing you on our screens in a very different attire. Can you talk a little bit about the physical transformation you had to go through for that role?
Well, yeah, it was a 4-hour prosthetic makeup job every day. I did that like 30 times. I had 30 filming days, but it was awesome. I mean, I shaved my head. It was a sort of fully immersive experience for me, transforming in front of the mirror like that. And it was a surprising character for me to be offered. I'm not usually offered parts that sort of intense.
Can you talk a little bit about, I guess, what you're hoping for if we do get a second season? Because obviously fans really pleased with the world, and obviously the first season's been a huge success. Are there specific things both for your character and for the world as a whole that you're hoping they get to explore in season two?
Well, I mean, the druids in the first season, they were the soothsayers, they were in charge, they were all powerful, but I get a feeling in subsequent series, they're going to fall from power. I mean, historically, we know that they do, so there's all that to look forward to.